By now, you are getting very familiar with the JASP workspace. You know how to set variables and how to select data. But our next skill set is very important. How do you take existing variables and use them to create new variables? For this example, we continue using the JASP data file called kitchen rolls. If you still have it open from the previous video, then carry on. But if not, click on the main menu icon. Open Data Library and choose T-Tests. Select the version of the kitchen rolls dataset with the JASP icon in the corner. We're going to use existing variables to create new variables. If we were doing this in SPSS, we would use the command transform compute variable. We would create a new variable by first giving the new variable a name and then creating a formula. This would be a total score, adding up four variables. We could make it a mean by dividing this total by four. This would create a new variable that we could use in further analysis. Now let me explain why we might do this. Many things in the world are simple to measure, such as the height of a structure or the weight of a person. Then there are things that we know exist but cannot be measured directly, such as intelligence, personality, or level of satisfaction with your job. Scientists create ways to measure these theoretically derived conceptions that we call constructs. Job satisfaction is a construct. It can't be measured in inches or pounds, but we have evidence that it exists, and we can construct a way to measure it. Theoretically, your overall job satisfaction may comprise multiple smaller constructs or subscales, like your satisfaction with your coworkers, your boss, your pay, or the benefits. Each of these subscales is discrete or distinct from each other. You can love your coworkers but hate your boss and be moderately satisfied with your pay. Each subscale will be measured using three or more items. Individual questions asking you about your satisfaction with pay, each in a slightly different way. And each of these items will be measured with a Likert scale, perhaps ranging from 1 to 5 or 1 to 7. We are going to focus on this array of ordinal data labeled NEO. Now, these are actually personality items, but we're going to choose four of them to stand in for our pay satisfaction subscale items. Right now, they are properly labeled as ordinal, but their being categorical will create a problem for us later when we want to do math with them. As we learned in the last video, if you're going to do math, our variables need to be set to scale. Change item 2 from ordinal to scale. Now do the same for items 3, 5, and 8. Any time that you plan to add or multiply or do any kind of math, set the level of measurement to scale, also known as continuous. First, we're going to create a total score, the sum of all four items in our supposed subscale, satisfaction with pay. Click on the black plus sign in the upper right corner. we're going to create a computed column called total using a drag and drop formula with the new variable being set to scale. Click to create the column. It will be added as a new column at the right end of the dataset. Drag and drop item 2, then plus sign. Now click on item 3. That is a quicker way to move a variable. Plus sign. Double click on item 5. Well, that added item 5 twice. We don't need that. Let's delete it. Drag the second item 5 to the trash, or the bin if you prefer, to be rid of it. Click the plus sign and add item 8. We are now ready to compute column. This is the sum, or total score, of the 4 items. Now we will create a mean. We could compute it with its own formula, but I want to show you how we can use a previously created variable in yet another new formula. Click on the black plus sign. Call the new variable pay, because this is the average satisfaction with pay subscale. Note that if you want to learn more, you can open the documentation and watch brief videos and read explanations. Click to create column. Let's use the total that we just created, and then divide it by 4. Dividing the total by 4 calculates the mean. You can also use this technique to return logical values. Create a nominal text variable called sex 2, in which we ask if sex equals capital F. JASP returns the true and false logicals. Notice that, like R, the values are case sensitive. So if you ask if sex equals lowercase f, all returned values are false. But what if you need numbers, such as 1 and 0 for doing a logistic regression? This time, create a scale variable called sex3, in which we ask if sex equals capital F. The resulting variable consists of 1 and 0, where females are assigned 1, or true, and males are assigned 0, or false. I can also use formulas that calculate the mean of a column. Now here I have some data for a set of ages. But I have some missing data. I'm in a hurry, so I want to replace all of the missing values with the mean of all of the remaining scores. And please, please, no nasty comments about mean imputation. We're just learning here. Create a new scale variable called ageImpute. Use the replaceNA function to replace the missing values in age with the mean of all of the age scores. Or I could create an entirely new distribution called normal. This is a normal distribution with a mean of 0, and a standard deviation of 1. If you want to remove a calculated column, click on the function sign to select the variable, and then this small trash can, or bin. If you already suspect that you see a lot of overlap with R, then you are correct. In fact, on any of the calculated columns, you can click on the R icon to see the code that is being used. Now, this code cannot be edited directly, but you can copy it and paste it, and then create a new variable using the R code option. And copy code into JASP. Now this, of course, is a total, but you can edit the R code, and now we have a mean. With R, there are multiple ways to do everything. We could use our rowMeans command and set our variables as a data frame to calculate a mean. Or we could use the apply function, again setting our variables as a data frame. Now, if you're familiar with coding in R, then you can use your coding skills and this example to calculate other scores, such as converting feet to meters. And of course, you can create new variables using R code of your own. Click on the black plus sign to add a computed column. Our new column would be called BMI. Using R code, and the new variable will be scale. In this data set, I have data for height in inches and weight in pounds. Remember that R is a calculator, so we can do the math directly. But we have to type the names of the variables. I can compute BMI using this formula. If you have followed along with these first 5 videos, you are now very familiar with the JASP workspace. You know how to set variables and how to select data. And you now know how to create new variables as needed. So I suppose that we should explore the multiple ways that we can export data or results out of JASP. Hey, you want a quick peek behind the scenes? Let me show you what's literally behind the scenes. Couldn't do it without you, buddy.